welcome everyone here tonight to our second budget meeting of the season. There's a lot of rumors going around about cuts and closings and things of that sort. But I'm looking out and I see many familiar faces from years gone by. And you know that this is the time of the year that rumors really do go around. So we're going to start our second meeting, budget meeting, with the same, right where we left off the last one. So I ask everybody's indulgent, please listen. This is not one of the meetings that we have people talking. The 27th, the regular board meeting will be held in this room also. We'll be set up with microphones in both aisles, and at that time we will listen to the public. I'm going to turn the meeting over to Mr. Pacella.
Thank you, Mr. Pizzo. What I'd like to do tonight is first, for those that have not been through this first process or in the process, go over to why we're here, this budget process, what we need to get to, and what was done to us by Albany that put the board in such a difficult situation. As you know, that the tax levy cap is now a law. It's a two-year law, and the budgets are going to be presented to voters that have been caused tax levy to be above the tax rate, and you need 60% or a supermajority of the voters to pass that. It will very rarely be 2%, and a simple majority of voters will have the power to block that tax increase. Newburgh's calculations for this tax cap comes to 2.63% on the levy, which is only $2,569,000 additional taxes that can be raised. Taking the current budget, rolling it over with the tri-borough laws, with certain pension factors, benefits factors, other inflationary costs, the school district's budget looks at, the preliminary budget was $240,800,000. You combine that with the taxes we're allowed to raise, it comes up to a current budget gap, or a preliminary budget gap, is $13.7 million. With that said, the first presentation, first budget workshop of the board, there were certain items that went down and recommended by the superintendent that were discussed and consensus was conformed, and I asked the board to take out the packet. First off, let me let you know there's an additional folder that was at your seat. Those are addendums. Item number 12 is your teacher on special assignment, which you requested last meeting. The 12 that was in your original packet that went home to you, it does have the recommendation on it, but this is a more comprehensive list, a little more accurate, and you have questions, we can address them as we get to that item. Also in there is the curriculum instruction additional recommendation that was also listed on your spreadsheet that it would be forthcoming today to the APPR requirements in Albany. CNI folks had to attend. I apologize for the delay in this, but this is the time that you can get it. And also, at the last meeting, you requested the foreign language counts and the continuum for the languages at both houses and our middle schools. That being said, I'll recap where you are today. With everything that you've come to consensus with a week and a half ago, you've agreed to reduce the current preliminary budget by $7,189,265. It's 83.5 positions. There are a couple of changes from that original schedule that you got last week because you made recommendations. One recommendation going down under athletics, you didn't take the recommendation for the modified teams. However, you did agree by consensus to eliminate the ski hockey teams. I didn't have the actual figures last week because I didn't realize that was going to come up. The actual figures now are in at $49,257. The security was also mistaken in security that there were two full-time equivalents and all the part-time positions that were eliminated. The math on the spreadsheet wasn't correct. It's actually higher now because when I did the spreadsheet for the original part-time employees, I didn't calculate them at three. I thought they were the same. So you'll see that was $247,000 worth of salaries and extra earnings combined, which was significantly higher than the last one. And lastly is the psychologists with the ESS assistance of the $70,000. Last week that was coupled with the social workers, but you tabled the social workers until a future date, so they are now part of the budget still. And reflected here in one of the two positions of the psychologists. That being said, with those $7.1 million coupled with what you need to get to, you'll see at the bottom of your spreadsheet, if you accept the recommendations tonight, you'll still be nearly $3 million away from the cap. Recommendations tonight, along with that gap, you need to find $6.5 million more to get under the legal tax cap. So at this time, I'll turn it over to you, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Costello. One announcement before I read a short statement. Ms. Resch will be here. She has been out of town on business and changed her arrangements to be here with us for this budget workshop this evening, and unfortunately her plane was delayed, so she will be joining us this evening as soon as possible, coming directly from Stewart Airport. In anticipation of this meeting, I put together a brief summary of some of our feelings and kind of where we are as a group, as a district. I want you all to know it's imperative that you understand that not one of us sitting here wants to make any of the cuts that we have before us this evening. The state government, our local legislators, they've made decisions and they've put us in a position where we find ourselves having to make unthinkable choices. I attended a state issues conference in Albany this past weekend, and sadly I must report that there is little, if any, help headed our way from once the executive budget is adopted. We have lobbied. We've lobbied for mandate relief. We've lobbied for cooperative purchasing agreements. We're currently the only state that does not have that. We've lobbied for health insurance, pension reform, reform in the state aid formula, all which proves to be totally inequitable, specifically to high-need, low-wealth districts. All of these items would benefit the districts greatly in trying to provide a sound and basic education for our students. But all of this information has fallen on deaf ears at the state level. The one potential resource that may be headed our way is a reallocation of $250 million, which is currently being set to be given based on performance grants. We do have some people lobbying for us to get 200 of the 250 million to be reallocated to school districts. When I asked the question to the government officials, do you realize that you are jeopardizing our ability to provide a sound and basic education, and you're forcing our school districts in this state into insolvency? I was met with the response, yes, we have reviewed that, and we know that within 3 years, 75% of the more than 700 school districts in the state will be in major fiscal crisis. Knowing that, they continue to make the decisions and continue with more unfunded mandates and no mandate relief for current unfunded mandates that are in place. I want you to know that we've received and we've reviewed your comments, many packets coming into us via email, via the board clerk, and many other ways. We appreciate the time and attention that you've given to submit your input to all of us, and we realize that you know we are in a very difficult situation and we need all the help that we can get. I implore you that we need to work together to do what is right for every child in this district. Many of you are not only employees, but taxpayers as well. And we all need to keep that in mind and share the responsibilities we have to all of you as well in doing what is right. Everyone realizes that these decisions affect people's lives. We're very aware of that, and that is what makes this process so difficult. A fellow board member shared with me a personal story earlier today, and it was about a little boy who was very ill, and they went to the doctors, and the little boy said, "But doctor, this isn't fair to me." And the doctor responded to the young man, "Well, Johnny, would it be fair if it was happening to someone else?" And that's what I want all of you to keep in mind when we're making these decisions. We know it affects each and every one of you, and it affects our children. So we have to come together. We cannot be willing to put one or another particular group aside. We need to keep the benefit of the whole forefront in our mind and realize we are here to educate the students in this district. So, we've all come out here to work together. We need to secure the future of each and every child in this district. And at the end of the day, we need to do that by finding $14.2 million. Please work with us and help us as we make these painstaking decisions to do what's right for everyone involved. Mr. DeSella?
Then you have your attachments, which are numbered on the right-hand corner. And then you have Schedule B, which is the alphabetized list that also has changed. We put two additional items under that we've added based on discussion from last week.
We left off on our list last time we were together with teachers on special assignments. We have been provided with a list of teachers on special assignment according to their assignments. The board members would like to know, and I will ask Mr. Forgeon, of the list that we received, which of those are mandated?
Madam President, items 1 and 2 on sheet number 12 refer to district data assessment specialists. These are data assessment specialists that are tied to the accountability system. These particular positions are required under the No Child Left Behind guidance. The next items are 18 through 24 CSE chairperson and CPSE chairperson. Those are required positions for the school district. Academic intervention services are required to be provided for all students that don't meet the criteria set in our academic interventions plan for the district. So English AIS teachers, the way our district calls them, also reading specialists also deliver academic intervention services primarily. They also do some embedded coaching while they're in classrooms, so those are also mandated positions. Math specialists and math AIS teachers, again, are mandated positions. And I have D on your list.
Most of the items on this list are mandated.
That's a combined position with the CSE chairperson as well, New York State Alternative Assessment Coordinator.
And the recommendation on the table this evening is for a reduction of 8 teachers on special assignment, for a reduction in the budget of $786,373. Open this item up for discussion. There on your sheet listed number 12, and the first 9 are the positions being recommended for elimination. The money's the same, so it's not...
Actions.
Yes, Mr. Levinstein. Can you pull the mic over, please?
These nine positions that are here, the people that are in these positions will then probably come somewhere else, so there will be nine people being let go.
Correct. Consensus on the reduction of teachers on special assignment by nine positions for a total reduction in the budget of $786,373. Ms. Prokash? Mr. Bestley? Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee? Mr. Levinstein? Yes. Item on the list for discussion is elementary teaching assistants. The recommendation calls for a reduction of 61 positions in elementary. As a reminder, we reduced the number of year, and it was painstaking decision. Unfortunately, due to the financial crisis we are forced into by Albany, we can no longer sustain the cuts for these positions and are fully aware of the impact this may have. If you remember, the district did not have these positions until the 2002-2003 school year. I'll open this item up for discussion. Yes, Mrs. McAfee. I believe 41. Mr. Lewis.
Well, you made a statement here that we didn't have these positions in 2003 school year. We didn't have teachers assistants, but we had teachers aides. So we did have some cuts here. Does this mean that all of the
this current recommendation does mean that. Yes, Ms. Prokash.
With the increase in population that we've had this year in kindergarten, we're at a crisis level. As far as trying to meet the needs of these children coming into our school system to get them ready in 12 years to graduate. I cannot see how we can possibly do that with having one teacher in a classroom for 28, 27, behind and a grade behind before they can start. Bringing our population up is a fact of life. We have to do that. If we can possibly save 41, 50, whatever, out of that, I would have to vote no on cutting this. I mean, I have some other ideas of how we can generate some money. I'm sure other people have ideas how to generate money. But academically, a teacher assistant, teaching assistant, can help that kindergarten teacher get those kids on the right path. I don't see how we can do it without that. It's not just taking a child to the bathroom. It's teaching a child how to do a letter, how to start reading, how to start in the right way. And if we don't do something now with that, we're absolutely doing it.
Ms. Brooks, I don't think there's anyone sitting at this table that doesn't agree with what you said.
I understand that, but we have to.
And we do have to find a way. So we're here to take suggestions from the people sitting around this table. If you want that back in totality, then you have to find
by 51% of the vote. 50% plus one vote, as Mike said. But that's no guarantee that it's going to pass. And if it doesn't, we have to come back to the drawing board to find out another $2.6 million. So we're kind of between a rock and a hard place with that. And the more people we make angry out here, I think the more people are going to come and vote no on the budget. So again, rock and hard place.
Mrs. McAfee.
I'd like a clarification. If we would put kindergarten on the budget as a separate proposition and then it didn't pass, that would mean kindergarten was eliminated.
Completely.
It
depends how you name it. It depends how you name the proposition.
And remember, kindergarten is not mandated.
We don't, yeah.
Let me just say that the superintendent's budget is the budget that you had in front of you. We purposely stayed away from kindergarten, whether it's half day or full day. We feel that the full day kindergarten as it stands now is the proper place for it. That's why it's in the budget the way it is. Also, I'm not saying this is just class. This is just business. But thank you, Mike. The other piece is that we stayed away from closing schools. We feel that it's not part of what we want to recommend to you. But if we're going to be putting things back that raises the number away from the tax cap, we're going to have to go to the alphabetized list, which has a number of things on it, to replace it. And that's not what's in the superintendent's recommendation. But if that's what we have to do to compromise, I'm perfectly willing to do that.
Yes, Mr. Levinsky.
Of all these items that are here on the presentation, I think that this is going to affect the children out of everything. So it certainly would be more for anyone to say that they want to do this. Now, I'd like to just repeat something that I did, thinking of something, maybe finding the money somewhere else. And it is going to explain why I have voted no. I would like to explain why I'm voting no to layoffs, eliminations of positions, and reductions of what we offer our students. This process is not working. For the last 3 years, the district has been laying off people, and there's no end in sight. Who are we going to let go next year? Now, we do need to reduce our budget by approximately $14 million. This is a task that is extremely difficult and not something anyone here would wish to. Also, no one in this room believes that these reductions and layoffs are in the best interest of our students. So how can we do things differently? This coming year, the district is budgeting $40 million for health insurance. This figure is approaching 20% of our total budget. It's a staggering amount and an expense that cannot be sustained. The only way that this expense can be reduced to avert layoffs and program reductions is if all employees help share in the cost of health insurance. Every employee paying a certain percentage would wipe out the $14 million shortfall that we have, thus saving jobs and preserving opportunities for our students.
Something that we should be doing at this table.
Yes, Mr. Mayor. I didn't get to answer my question, so that we can't do anything about that in time to affect.
Anyone have any other ideas where we can get $3 million so that we can save something that's very important, as is everything that we're looking to eliminate? I'll take consensus. I know what the consensus is going to be, but without a plan of where we're going to get this money at the end of the day, we still need what we need. Go ahead.
We're still in the process.
Mm-hmm.
We're still in the process. So before the final decision is made, we should take the consensus on, I think, what Ms. McAfee said, at least for the time being, saying that separate, and I love the people of 61, but separate for right now.
Let me try and answer that. We're in the second meeting. If you feel as though you're coming up to an item that's going to be difficult, you want to do something with it, rearrange it somehow, or eliminate it, then we can do that. What we have to do is take a consensus on bubbling it, or if you use it in the past, and we move on to the next item and come back to this one, especially later on. We might not get there tonight, but we still have a month and a half to go with meetings. And that's perfectly okay.
Okay, so we'll take consensus on that?
We'll take consensus on separating the kindergarten teaching assistants. Mr. Vesper? Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein? Ms. Prokash? Yes. I will take consensus on bubbling the 41 teaching assistants.
The consensus that you just took was to separate them or to eliminate the 20? What was it?
Sorry.
Just to separate. Okay.
Can you figure out the numbers under?
Yeah. The 20 first grade that are left is $896,725 savings.
Right, I'll take consensus on the elimination of 20 teaching assistants in the first grades for a reduction to the budget of $896,725. Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein? Ms. Prokash?
No.
Mr. Vesely? Yes. Now, take consensus to bubble the 41 teaching assistants for the kindergarten. Mr. Lewis? Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein? Ms. Prokash? To bubble. So would I.
I want to bubble when you're going out. I'll bubble. Bubble
means we're going to discuss it.
We're going to come up with somewhere else to get that done.
Right.
Mr. Bessler. Mr. Bessler. Item on the list is the reduction of a telephone operator at NFA for a reduction to the budget of $61,634. Due to the telephone technology, there is no longer a need for this position at the high school. Open this up for comments. Okay. take consensus on the elimination of telephone operator at NFA with a reduction in the budget of $61,634. Mrs. Mathey?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein? Ms. Brokosh?
Yes.
Mr. Bestley?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
The next item on the agenda is a reduction of a transition specialist at NFA. Reduction in the budget would be $76,780. There currently are two specialists at the high school, and it is being recommended to reduce to one. Questions or comments on this item? Take consensus on the reduction of one transition specialist at NFA for a reduction in the budget of $76,780. Mr. Levinstein? Ms. Prokosh?
Yes.
Mr. Bestley?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. Mathey?
Yes.
The next item on the list is a reduction of the violence prevention coordinator. A reduction in the budget of $102,030. This position has been vacant for the current school year, and the recommendation is now to fill it for economic reasons only. Questions or comments on this item? Yes, Mr. Bessie.
Homeless socialization and violence prevention coordinator go together? Could they do double duty?
Combine homeless liaison responsibilities with the responsibilities assigned to the violence prevention coordinator.
That's not our plan at this point, but that's the question.
I think we know that's not the plan. I guess the question is that something that would be feasible?
Without looking at it further, I would have to say off the top of my head, I don't think it is feasible. Read the newspaper.
Thank you.
Yes, Mrs. Mathieu.
Is it a full-time position as a long-term person? No. So, I don't see how the person could be that time.
Yes, Mr. Stiller.
Yeah, just the crime prevention coordinator, some of you may have been on board that time. When we entered the discussions with the council community, there was a whole program, and we were supposed to get funding for that whole program. So we retained the crime prevention coordinator, but actually didn't get into the program for the council community, because it is a full curriculum. So that's kind of like, I know that you folks were on board, just for those that weren't, the council community was supposed to be the program to start deterring violence. We didn't get the full program, but we did retain the board.
I would like to put them together, if I would like that position to be...
Be revisited. So I will take consensus to bubble the violence prevention coordinator. Ms. Prokash? The violence prevention coordinator. That position. Mr. Beston?
Yes.
Mr. Whitmore?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee? Mr. Levinson? Yes. Four yes, three no. So that would be both. Our next item on the agenda is a reduction of two physical education positions at NFA for a savings of $142,779. This will increase the current class size, but with a more refined scheduling process, it is determined that this reduction could occur. Questions or comments on this? Take consensus on the reduction of two physical education positions at NFA for a reduction in the budget of $142,779. Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Mr. Whitmore?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson? Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Yes. Next item on the agenda is in regards to music. It calls for the elimination of instrumental programs at the elementary level. It is a reduction of six positions at a reduction of the budget of $600,949. Again, due to economic purposes, it is recommended to eliminate the instrumental program at the elementary level. The fine and performing arts director has provided recommended levels of teaching positions at each school. Comments on this item?
I think this would do a school and a half, and go into
As long as you have the votes, it's possible.
Okay.
We're not supposed to have a way to vote.
I'll take your consent.
Otherwise, I mean, if we don't have, you know, then we're just not going to have a little license. And that's a leader to be enforced. Keep getting credit for it. And I just say it's a lot more.
I'll take consensus on bubbling the elementary music instrumental program with an elimination of six positions. Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Mr. Whipple?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mr. McAfee? Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Next recommendation on the list is the elimination of an art program at NFA in photography. Would be the elimination of one position. The reduction of the budget of $107,142. Due to enrollment, this course is being recommended for elimination. Yes, Ms. Prokash?
I just want to make sure that with this, because I know the part B is involved, but she basically the first time this was retired to the other years. But I know that there's there was an overload this year for studio art classes that were 30 instead of public studio. I just want to make sure that there's coverage and there would be enough coverage to so those classes that have two versions required, first year and artists required, that we have, we're not going to have ourselves with that, we have enough coverage for teachers of that course. That would be my concern. If we do find that some further.
Do you know the answer to that, Mr. Porter? Positions for a reduction in the budget of $214,100. Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash? Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Mr. Whipple?
Yes.
Our next item on the list is a reduction of one assistant principal for a reduction in the budget of $96,682. The district has received a retirement letter, and the recommendation is to not backfill the position. Since Gibney Avenue School is not slated to expand this year to K-6, one of the assistant principals will be switched from this school to fill the vacancy. Questions or comments on that? I'd just like to say that we'll be postponing this for a short period of time, because obviously when GAMS begins their move to K-8, we would be looking to put back that position to keep it in line with the other K-8 buildings in regards to the number of assistant principals they have. But it's a temporary relief for this year. Take consensus on the reduction of one assistant principal position for a reduction in the budget of $96,682. Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Mr. Whitmore?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Yes. The next item on the agenda is the leasing of West Street School to BOCES. It's a reduction of 1.5 positions with a total savings to the district of $233,296. Per the board's direction, the district has been able to secure a leasing proposition from an interested party. At this time, it is not appropriate to divulge too much information at the request of the renter. The cost savings and revenue can be discussed. Cost savings, as noted here, would be $233,296. Questions or comments on the statement? Yes, Mr.
Yes, I agree. Doing this sounds wonderful. I just want to make sure that we're not caught doing any costs other than, you know, leasing the building and getting paid. We don't want to be having to take care of boilers or things like that, possibly go to the roofs.
Your point's well taken. We will discuss the actual contract with the board. We have to vote on that. That has to be in executive session. At least the first part of it.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Any other questions on this item at this time? I'll take consensus on the leasing of the West Street School for a reduction in the budget of $233,296. Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Mr. Whitmore?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Yes. Our next item on the list are additional Schedule J recommended reductions for a savings in the budget of $22,486. The additional recommended items are on sheet number 17. Into that, Mr. Coach?
be part of the curriculum in one of our local courses. However, I want to put a position on those two items.
Can I have consensus to remove those two items so that Mr. Forge can get further clarification as to how they tie into the curriculum and the coursework? Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Mr. Bessie?
Yes.
Mr. Whitlow?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis? Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Ellison?
Yes.
Do we have any other questions on the remaining items for the Schedule J reduction recommendations? Okay, then I'm going to take consensus on the remaining Schedule J reductions. Mr. Beston?
Yes.
Mr. Whitlow?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Did you have something else you wanted to ask about Schedule J right now?
I actually think we should look further for next session on Schedule J. Because I'd rather be on Schedule J than on teacher.
Or teaching assistant. Additional recommendations from CNI. PR training requirements, this recommendation could be totally completed at the time of the distribution of this packet. So Mr. Forge was to be handing it out this evening, which he did. Recommendation that we have before us, and Mr. Forge, please correct me if I'm wrong, at the March 5th, 2012 budget workshop, the Board of Ed voted to approve the elimination of 7 curriculum directors. Based on further dialogue by senior staff, the superintendent would like to recommend a modification to the original recommendation. increase curriculum directors by 3. Based on further dialogue with senior staff, the superintendent would like to add the following recommendations slated for the March 15, 2012 budget workshop. Reduce teachers on special assignment by an additional 2. Elementary French at Meadow Hill and funded programs at Central Office. And reduce teachers on special assignment by an additional 3 instructional coaches. And reduce the curriculum and instructional consultant line item budget by $6,000. So that's what's reflected in this packet.
For 0 change.
For 0 change. Basically, it's reallocating staff. We asked that we look to see if there were any other assistant coaches that might be eliminated.
This year we took the assistant coach from hockey that was not filled and used that to have an additional assistant coach for her.
Across athletics.
Possibly reduce other assistant coaching positions that weren't required for health and safety.
Yeah, we did that before. Last year's budget, we did eliminate, I believe, four, three or four assistant coaches on smaller teams. we didn't look at the remaining assistant coaches because they are becoming larger teams.
Yeah, but also some that weren't as large, but...
We can look at it, yeah.
I don't think they're large, but there were some other ones that could.
We'll have that for the next budget.
And we did receive quite a lot of support for all three of these teams, which we certainly understand. The recommendation that was made at the last budget workshop was made based upon the fact of how many students would be impacted. And the reasoning was we felt that less students would be impacted, although we know this is important to these students, and we respect that. Looking at the larger picture and how many students are going to be affected by these eliminations that have to be made, we felt that keeping the modified program would affect less students as opposed to eliminating specific teams. Not an easy decision by any stretch of the imagination, and we certainly understand the passion. Many of us have had our own children or family members involved in these specific sports. And also, there was some mention of concern whether there would be, if other districts were to eliminate their modified sports, then who would we have to compete with? So if we didn't have enough competition amongst ourselves, and we do find that other districts have eliminated freshman and modified sports, then certainly this could be an item that could be revisited to go back to then eliminate, if we didn't have anyone to compete with, eliminate modified sports and reinstate these teams. Yes, Ms. Prokosh. If not, it's back to the drawing board, it's putting our thinking caps on. Recap where we are.
Yeah, tonight by consensus, you've agreed to eliminate $721,000. 38.5 positions. And you are at a budget gap of $5.8 million. The $721,000 deduction net includes that health insurance adjustment of $1.9 million.
Yes.
Was generated primarily through advertisements.
Yes.
about the cell towers, we did explore that. We do have a tower at NFA. The problem is that the amount of revenue that we generate would not cover the cost, because the companies that we've been dealing with are requiring us to maintain the towers and the poles.
We talked about at the law, Ms. Linder and I read the same one, that wasn't something that was, they told us that that was not the case.
Well, the cell companies that we've been talking to, that has been the case. They've actually sent us contract and leasing documents that certainly spells that out.
But that's something we got to know. Because I mean, we're coming in, and I understand how hard work is done down at the central administration, but we're voting on sometimes and getting on the same way as people here. We don't know that at all. We have to get a little bit more, you know, back and forth that way. So that when we're voting on, 100% knowledge on certain things, which I think, that's not. I also think we have to look in different departments in central administration.
Woo!
Appreciate your input, especially in front of the crowd. Thank you very much. I do have to say that yes, you do say it privately. We do have cuts downtown. We're working on it. Pardon? Well, we don't have a deputy superintendent. Yeah, I'm not going to get into the debate with you. I know we're easy targets for you. And as we said before earlier tonight, there's nobody up here that likes what's going on. But we're all taking the cuts equally. And we'll have the percentages of administration, CSEA, teachers, and TAs finished at the end of this budget process. I promise you. My wife out there, I think I hear her in the crowd. Thank you for your input.
Another thing we have to do, we need to set the next budget workshop meeting. Looking at next Thursday, March 22nd at 6 p.m. here in the auditorium. Also, the board workshop March the 20th, Tuesday, March the 20th, will also be here in the auditorium, as well as the Board of Education meeting on March 27th. At that time, obviously, we'll be taking public comments, and that is the reason that we're moving to this venue, as we anticipate a large crowd. I do just want to remind everyone that based on our policies and procedures around public meetings and speaking at public meetings, there is allotted time of 30 minutes on agenda items, of which budget would not be an agenda item, and 30 minutes on non-agenda items. I will be permitting the time that is not used on agenda items, whatever is left over in that 30-minute period, I will tack on to the non-agenda items to give some more time for people to speak. I know many of you want to speak in regards to the budget, so I will be allowing that. There will be a timekeeper, and there will be no more than 5 minutes per person speaking. So please organize yourselves in representing your particular group when you come to address the board with what you would like to address us with.
And for the next meeting, would suggest to board members, we are still $5,797,675 short of the cap. So I would suggest that you look very carefully at your alphabetized list and see, remember how we set this up? That the more you take out, the closer we get to the list, the more you put back, the higher it goes. So you have to, that's the money, that's that. Everybody can clap and talk and say what they want. The bottom line is that $5 million plus. So it's almost six. So that's our task, to get up to that 14.2. So look at the alphabetized list and make your agonizing decisions.
Also, just to feedback, Madam President, since we only have 1 week, and I only have 1 week to cost these out, if you can send them to me as soon as possible, otherwise I won't be able to have that information at that time.
Thank you. Any other questions from the board? Be it resolved that the board hereby recesses into executive session for the following purpose: to discuss the purchase or lease of real property. The board will not be taking action after the executive session. Can I have a motion? Roll call, please.